Hey guys, this is Primeval, and in this series, as per requests from my Twitch chat, we're going to be playing the Necrophages again. So we played them already on normal difficulty, and revealed what seemed like a really interesting main faction quest. We had captured a human, or some sort of a biped. The Necrophages referred to them as hind legs, and he was a scientist, and he was going to help us make improved hybrid necrophages, and it seemed like a really interesting story. I'm very curious to see where that story goes, but in our last playthrough we ended up getting a supremacy victory or something like that, and so I never found out where the main faction quest went. So this time we're going to play on impossible. This is the second hardest difficulty, and we're going to go and try to win the wonder victory, and so that's following all of the steps in the main faction quest. And we'll leave all the other victories enabled, and so we have to win that wonder victory before one of the impossible AIs beats us to it in any of those score categories. No custom factions. We're gonna play on two continents. I haven't played with those settings before, and with the world difficulty on normal. So notably, that means the minor faction difficulty is normal. I've heard that the AI can have trouble if you set the minor faction difficulty too high, and I've also had a lot of trouble with the minor factions, at least in multiplayer games. So we're playing an 8-player game here. I'm the Necrophages, and all the rest are random. So let's watch the intro video here. I know that those of you who've seen my first video probably saw that already, but it's good for the story, and all right. Thank you, Firestormer. I'm glad you enjoy my vids, and thank you very much for the donation. I am now collecting donations, and if you donate to me while I'm on stream, you'll get a pop-up on the screen like this. And if you donate when I'm not streaming, then I'll thank you later in a later video. But yeah, that's great. I'm trying to get money to buy a new video card.
The colony was everything. They were born as one. They fought as one. And they died as one. Driven by their hunger. But I hunted for something more. I stole the sentience of an ancient power and saw a greater purpose. For we were the first. Auriga is our planet. And I will turn our hunger against those trespassers who would take it from us. One day we will reign supreme on Auriga. And we will gaze up at the stars. Still hungry.
Alright, so if we need range units in order to abuse the AI, we're going to have to hope that one of the first minor factions we come across gives us a ranged unit. Seems like a good plan. We'll see what we can find. We've got the massive tree right here. That's a food and production boost. Another massive tree to the south. A gold luxury deposit. Ah, Weatherman's here. So, doing multiplayer is still an option. Weatherman, do you have any friends online who we could get together to do another Endless Legend multiplayer match? So these guys are the boss. If anyone remembers what kind of unit the boss makes, let's see. Minor faction, cavalry. No, that's not going to do it for us. Alright, now, best settling locations. We are food poor, so something like getting a massive tree would help us out with that. We could expand into all the forests for a lot of production. There is this river that runs through the entire territory, which would help us with dust if we went aqua plovistics. I think I'm just going to go and wander over towards that life tree. Either this tree or that tree. Over here, it's less food, but more forests. Alright, so if we dropped right here, we would have 7 food per turn. But a lot of production. Let's do that. And we'll go Founder's Vault. Our hero, what sort of skills does our hero have? Slavery. Increases the per person value for food and industry for each pacified village. So if we could pacify a number of villages, slavery would give us a nice bonus, including 2 food. But otherwise, I think he'll be more useful for us for pacifying these villages. 2 centaurs versus 1 forager and 1 hero, or do we need to bring both of our foragers over? It's probably safer if we do go and bring both of our foragers over. Scout down here, assign the hero, save on a little upkeep. And as for our first research, we are low on food, so getting the siege storage up early seems like a good plan. And we are also very low on science in this spot. Well, we might have to get the library up then too, so maybe something like that. Well, we'll decide after the mill foundry finishes. It's going to be a 10 turn mill foundry, which is quite the long wait. Alright, so we have a quest. Yes, I was really liking the way the quest was heading when we did our first Let's Play on normal. Unease riddles the nest. I can feel it everywhere, in the hurried footfalls, in the tunnels, in the huddling, in the lingering, in the fungal gardens. They doubt me. The sifters, the burrowers, the soldiers, even the blasted groomers. Get off, they all doubt me. And their doubt seeps into my chitin. I sit in my lair, fret, 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 fretting, while above hind legs grow bolder, nipping and harrowing and slicing our tracks. Enough, I must erase these doubts, but how? Doubts bite deeper than my jaws. Full bellies, yes, full bellies will give them solace. Otherwise, they begin to eye one another hungrily. Otherwise, the weak will be ripped apart by the strong. That can't happen. That mustn't happen. We will attack the hind legs. Tender flesh for my hungry brood, but tender flesh protected by coats of steel, defended by spiked arms. They'll stab and slice us, but the price will be worth it. My brood will feed. My brood will gain confidence. We will grow. Alright, so with a main army exclusively composed of necrophage units, win 3 battles. We can do that. Alright, so perhaps tomorrow we'll get a multiplayer going with Lucky Strike. And yes, Ashlanti, the necrophage names like Belly Slicer, very descriptive of different actions. It does also remind me of the stereotypical Native American names. Alright, so first things first, we'll go and pacify this village. That'll complete step one of our quest. Well, a third of our first quest piece. Let's go attack that. Should be fine here, just some centaurs. Plus we have backup for our militia if we do need that help. Alright, so we can sit people. These guys will come at us regardless, so let's just have the morale boost on the hero there. How much movement does our hero have? 2 movement, that was enough to get over here. No space for that second militia to attack from. That's fine, we've got a full surround. Unless them moving first messes up all of our plans. Alright, so this all looks fine. Our foragers are taking a little damage here. Poison finished that last guy off. That's pretty useful. Okay, so we could lose this forager here, which would set us back. Ah, but poison saved the day. Perfect. And was that our militia taking damage from poison? That's kinda crazy. Alright, well, I think my foragers will need to heal up. We got some cadaver points out of that, I'm assuming. But not enough to be useful for anything. Now, is the only place we can check cadaver points at the end of a battle? Well, while we're healing, we can explore the rest of the territory here. And if we're going to use our guy as a governor, we should rebuild some of these villages so we can take advantage of that slavery bonus. And should we get rolling with some more units? Yes, if we do need to win a lot of fights, more units would be useful for that. Dust. Not bad. We don't seem to have a very large region, unless it extends on further to the north. We've gained a level. Let's see, do I want to use this guy as a army leader? In which case, increased hero defense, life on all units, accessory slot, defense, extra reinforcement positions in the garrison, and winter immunity. Well, this would definitely counteract our food shortage. Necrotic agriculture. Alright, let's anticipate turning this guy into a governor then. Although, we will need to buy a new hero if we are going to press the military advantage versus these impossible AIs. Alright, I think we've seen enough. We'll go attack this village. We're almost back to full health, and then we'll equip or assign our hero as a governor, use his food bonus. We're pumping food on that third citizen. We'll shift over to production. Alright, mill foundry done. We are pumping science very slowly, so let's get a library to offset that. And if we built a burrow, we could swallow up one enchanted forest tile, which doesn't really help with our science. Alright, let's go attack in this village. Earthspine. Well, we're not going to be expanding over in that direction. But that wouldn't have been a bad city location. I guess it's right at the edge of the map, so we probably wouldn't actually, or edge of the province, so we wouldn't actually settle there. Orcs. If we want range units, we should absorb these orcs. I do like orcs. Alright, so we'll also work on a settler then. The foragers do move first. They have a speed of 2. The orcs are going to do a number on us, especially since they're in this high ground choke. Yep, and we're moving slowly through forests. Alright, so this is actually going to be a disaster. Maybe we should just retreat and come back when we have the necro drones. Yes, what we'll do is we'll send this guy back. The orcs only have speed 3, but they shouldn't be able to move too quickly through the forest. We'll send one guy back. Unless he dies. Alright, we'll send this guy back further still. And let's see how powerful our hero is. Not very. Alright, so the hope is then that our hero delays things while this guy runs away. And then we can get our hero revived for the last stand. We are playing on impossible. Alright, so now if we lose our hero, we lose everything. We lost both of our foragers, although our hero has been able to take these guys down on his own. Alright, so that ended that. I don't know if I want to leave them. I kind of really want to take this guy down. But we can't do that right now. We'll need Necrodrone reinforcements. That was a disaster. Thick forests and then on a hill. I guess we could have gotten that information just by looking at the terrain right here. Oh, and another faction has already expanded to the Orc region. Alright, so let's get out of there then. In fact, I'll just go and assign a governor. Okay, we've met the Broken Lords. And do we need this Necrodrone right now? Or should we prioritize the Mill Foundry? So we are trapped in behind the Broken Lords, as far as I can tell. That means we're gonna have to build a strong army and go and attack them. The thing is, they'll be able to out-tech us. We start with the Necrodrone working on the library. Geomic Labs, how many science spots do we have? Just 3, so that's not going to help us too much. But if we want to complete this quest, we do need to go and fight some more battles. Alright, well, we don't have to worry about that until the cooldown on our hero ends. So we can lower the priority on that Necrodrone, either get some titanium rolling in, or rebuild that boss village, especially since we've got Feed on Bones here with his slavery ability. Alright, so is that just another hit of the next turn button? I believe it is. And we can delay this Necrodrone even more by queuing up a public library. Imagine the Necrophage using a public library. That's a fun image. Alright, so, seed storage? Sure. And then maybe the Empire Mint into the resource extractor. Yeah, a minimap would be nice. I do like how you get the sort of abstract form when you do the full zoom out. But a minimap would be helpful. Alright, an empire plan. We do have enough influence that if we wanted to, we could... Well, unit cost reduction, we're not building units yet, and we won't probably for the next 10 turns, so perhaps science. Especially since we're about to finish that public library. We'll go grab the titanium extractor. Nice one, silly pseudonym. I do hope they laminate the pages at the public library that these necrophage are using. Alright, feed on bones has gained some experience. It's a sign. Let's see, even more food. That's pretty amazing. Or 12% reduction, cost reduction. Let's go with more food here. Another plus 8 food. That's really good. Alright, so we've more than made up for our agricultural incompetence, or whatever it's called. Agriculturally challenged. Alright, so we could start working on this necrodrone, or we could work on a burrow. I guess we could burrow towards the river. What's over here? Or towards the mutant marsh. Would give us more science. We can also work on leveling up a district. Going over this way, if we had built a burrow instead of the titanium extractor, that would have saved us some hammers. Or some production cost. Alright, let's expand towards... the mutant marsh would be nice. Alright, we'll just eat our mistake here and build over the resource extractor. So we're pumping the science a little faster now with that public library done. Getting the seed storage would also be good, although during winter I don't expect we'll have too long of a winter. But we'll go with that. And let's make these units a little stronger, although more expensive. So edit that. Go and give this guy some armor. Sharp sense as well. And what about the forgers? We could give them armor too. Yes, you can save or pre-build units just like in Civ 5. Alright, so we don't need the seed storage now. The seed storage does have a little upkeep. Then again, so do units. We could build out another burrow, get closer to that mutant marsh. Alright, during the winter, that's what we'll do. Alright, an army composed of all Malay units is not going to have an easy time taking down our neighbors, the Broken Lords, if that's even possible. But we will make ourselves an army of 4 units, and then see what we can do. At least we'll want to complete the first step of our questline. If we're trapped in, I don't know how we're going to break the Broken Lords. Maybe I should be playing on a less crowded map. Alright, so we're back to summer. We can finish that seed storage. We may as well finish off that last Burrow Street. Can we finish them both at the same turn now? Alright, how are we going to do this? As the Necrophage, the standard plan for someone other than the Necrophage for beating the AI is to build a strong ranged army, but we're going to have trouble doing that here. Pull up the Empire Mint. And research-wise, we need two more techs to get into the next era. Mercenary market would be good. We do have dust saved up this time if we want to buy ourselves a hero. And let's see. Sewer system might be good to have since we have built a bunch of burrows. Alright, so we have recycling. That's plus one cadaver per unit killed in battle, as long as we win the battle, and eight cadavers gets us a stockpile, which gets us a food boost. There's a drawback for agriculturally challenged. Cellulose mutation. Each district only requires one population instead of two, so we actually could build a whole bunch of burrows there. And we have plus two food per person working food in cities, so that counters our agriculturally challenged downside. Fast epimorphous, increased healing. Pitiless, there's no diplomacy, no peace or alliances. Plus four per attack per unit when we, per faction we have declared war against. Cannon fodder reduced upkeep, so we can field a larger army without much trouble, and we can sacrifice population in cities to boost our approval. Very cool. And then the rest are units and our main quest line.